We have a vendor. What do you say? Most salespeople will try to overcome this objection by saying things like this. We have quite a few customers like X and Y who have switched from your product to ours because of A, B, and C. Or X had a vendor too, but what they found was A, B, and C. Or I'd expect you would. I'm just reaching out to show you how we're different. Responses like these destroy your credibility because prospects can smell your commission breath. They know you're putting your best interest before theirs. When you persuade and push back, it feels like you're on an ocean riding rough waves. The more you push, the rougher it gets, the more prospects push back. Persuading doesn't get you very far. Prospects dig their heels in even deeper. It's called the backfire effect. So what you need is a different approach that takes you down here to the bottom of the ocean, a place where it's nice and calm, a place where prospects feel comfortable opening up and telling you the truth, which is, yes, they'd like to continue the conversation, or no, they don't at this time. A place where you feel comfortable detaching from the outcome and letting go of assumptions that it's your job to persuade people, and instead to create an environment that allows prospects to persuade themselves. So let's talk more about having conversations at the bottom of the ocean. For context, this is my brother's company on the left-hand side. He has a company called Animal Pharmaceuticals that he recently sold. The product over there is called Grinders, and it is a product to keep dogs' teeth clean and healthy. Vets already solved that problem with Orivet, product on the right-hand side. The problem with Orivet is that it's expensive, and not all customers can afford it, so they neglect their dog's teeth. Here we are at the bottom of the ocean, the calm place, and you're seeing four rectangles. Each of those rectangles represent parts of a framework that you're going to learn based on the work of Chris Voss. The first thing to keep in mind is that we have a vendor is not an objection. It's the truth. Your prospect does, in fact, have a vendor. Everyone you reach out to is getting the job done the best way they know how. So we want to look at that as not something to overcome, but instead to understand. And you might start by using a label. A label describes the underlying emotion that someone's probably thinking. So if someone has Orivet, they might be happy with it. So you might just call that out and say, sounds like you're happy. And if you pause after you say that in a calm voice, prospect will typically respond. They might say something short like, I am, or yeah, we're happy, but. Pausing gives people space to talk. And when people talk and feel understood, they're more open to what it is that you have to say. After that, we can go to sentiment to see how they feel about how they're getting the job done today. So you might say, how's it going with Orivet? Customers liking it? A lot of people buying it? Is it moving off the shelves pretty well? And again, this gets back to making people feel heard and understood. From there, we'll go to a positive label. We'll list all the great reasons why they made a fantastic decision with their current solution. We want to make people feel good about the decision that they made so that we don't hurt their ego. And that might sound like this. Hey Doc, as you know, Orivet's a great product. Delmoplanol is a highly effective active ingredient, creates a great barrier to prevent attachment of bacteria to teeth, tongue, and gums. Again, this gets back to making people feel heard and making them feel good about what it is that they decided to buy. And then finally, we're going to go to illuminate. This is where we're going to shine a light on the cost of inaction, but we're going to ask a question that allows the prospect to solve the problem rather than us solving the problem for them. Chris Voss calls this a calibrated question, and it might sound like this. Hey, just curious, oftentimes I speak to front-end office staff, and they tell me there's customers that aren't able to keep their dogs on Orivet due to cost. What options do you have to service customers in those situations? You see what we're doing here? We're allowing the prospect to solve the problem to see if there's any motivation for switching. Because you don't create motivation, you only align with it. Hopefully this framework helps you get to the bottom of the ocean and have more conversations with prospects. Knowing what to say to make people feel heard is a superpower for getting through to anyone in your personal and your business life.